My Dallas Cowboys, glory be, are back in business. Now they have a bye week with which to get completely healthy for a game at his New York Giants 2 weeks from last night, which is just ahead of a Thursday showdown on Thanksgiving against the Philadelphia Eagles at Jerry World. Life is now good in Dallas, Texas again, thanks to as tough a quarterback as there is in the National Football League. That is one Tony Romo. You can rip and slash him all you want for his occasional blunders on the field, but when it comes to toughness, physical toughness, he just played with two cracked bones in his back. A game that his team desperately needed him to play, albeit against a below-average football team, but a dangerous one nonetheless, that had the third most sacks in the National Football League coming into this game. And Tony Romo sucked it up, and he gutted it out after an overseas flight. And I didn't think he played just pretty well. I thought he played great yesterday. He was off to a little bit of a slow start. He looked a little stiff. He couldn't rotate into his throws. He had lost a little velocity maybe in the first quarter. But as his back warmed up, he was back, baby. What did he go? 20 for 27 for 246, three touchdowns, and zero interceptions. And guess who else was back? His man, Dez Bryant, because Dez got his boy back yesterday. He got Romo back. The rapport was back. Why Brandon Whedon and Dez Bryant have zero rapport, I don't know. They played together at Oklahoma State, but they have zero rapport. And all of a sudden, Dez turned into Mega Dez yesterday. He ran as angry and as possessed as I've ever seen him run. It was as if his life depended on him getting the football after catch into the end zone, and he often carried three DBs with him. It was a pleasure to watch. And it was also a pleasure to finally have my offensive line back healthy and whole again. Doug Free was back. Ron Leary was back. And that line dominated the Jacksonville Jaguars, who barely touched Tony Romo until his final play of the game, in which he was finally sacked for the first time. Here comes a bye week, baby. I'm back. Thank you. Boo yourself. I'm finished. You can have the floor now. Go ahead. Try to undercut it. Try to ridicule it.
Just a couple of notes.
Yeah.
just a couple of notes, points of interest, ladies and gentlemen. Jaguars are the youngest team in the NFL. They do have a rookie quarterback. They play as many as eight rookies on offense. They've been decimated by injuries in the defensive side of the ball. They're dead last in turnovers committed in the NFL with 22. They've got a turnover ratio of minus 11. In other words, they're pretty close to pathetic. And that's at home. We ain't even get to the fact that they got to travel overseas to play a game. So we take all of these things into consideration. And then we have to look at where we're doing the show from today. We're on a military base. We're talking about servicemen and women. We're talking about America, tried and true, red, white, and blue, the epitome of excellence, the greatest country in the world. And America's team is the Cowboys?
Yes. Yes.
Let me get this straight. Because,
yes.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
I allowed
Thank you,
to
you
speak.
For acknowledging
I did
that.
Allow you to speak. I did allow you to speak. When we talk about America, are we talking about mediocrity? Of course we're not. But the Dallas Cowboys have one playoff victory in the last 17 years. They have missed the playoffs the last 4 years. The last 3 years, they have been a walking piece of mediocrity, 8-8, having lost the final game of the regular season to the Giants, to the Redskins, to the Philadelphia Eagles. And not only have they lost the division, they've lost it to everybody in the division. So now, as we sit here, because they have finally decided to return to the land of respectability, they won a game. They go overseas, and Tony Romo is back. How is he back? Because he showed up against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Really? Really? Y'all are something else. I'm going to be nice
today.
It's
not y'all, it's
me. I'm going to be nice. You did point out that there were Cowboy fans here before the show.
I see one.
All I'm saying to you is this.
Thousands.
All I'm saying to you is this.
Right here.
Thank you.
I see
you. Thank you.
I see these.
All I'm saying is, Tony Romo showed up. He deserves credit for the two little bones cracked in his back.
You are Stephen A.
But what I'm saying to you is this.
No big deal, just two little bones in his back.
I'm going to tell you why there was no big deal. Because the man was barely touched. It was a game. It was like shadow football.
Oh,
you understand?
Okay.
I mean, give me a break. So what? It means absolutely nothing. They could have beaten the Jacksonville Jaguars with Brandon Whedon. They sat up there, put poor Jerry Jones' wife in coach so he could fly first.
That was a joke. It didn't happen.
Did they give him a massage? Did they give him a pedicure? Did they do his fingernails? What did they do? I mean, did they cut his hair too?
Your witness, counselor.
What did they do for him?
Go ahead.
Is he finished, Carrie?
Go ahead, counselor.
I have a question for Mr. Smith.
Yeah, man.
Our NFL guru on this show, repeating history back to me. History I know better than he does.
You do know it better than me.
What happened?
No, I'm telling the truth.
What happened when the red-hot Cleveland Browns of one Brian Hoyer? What happened when they recently went to Jacksonville? What happened in that game?
They lost.
They lost 24-6. The Cleveland Browns, red-hot Cleveland Browns, lost to the Jacksonville Jaguars 24-6.
It also happens to be the only game Jacksonville won this year.
Okay, but they did win that game. They did win that game, which is why they're dangerous. And my team, my Cowboys, could not have won with Brandon Whedon yesterday because we saw how Brandon Whedon stunk it up against the Arizona Cardinals. So to sum this up, I'm going to hold your feet to the fire after all your 8-8 talk.
Yeah.
Will my Dallas Cowboys make the playoffs? You have to be on the record. He's a yes. So they will make the playoffs.
But I do believe they will not win the division. I believe the Philadelphia Eagles will win the division.